Hello, everybody. It's time for Science Notes. Today's topic is characteristics of scientific knowledge. You've already learned about the skills of science, observation, prediction, inference, etc., that scientists need in order to do their job. There are some characteristics of scientific knowledge, however, that also need to be learned. One of those is skepticism. Skepticism is an attitude of doubt. Scientists just don't take your word for anything that you say. They want you to show proof of what it is that you're claiming is true. They want to see the proof. They want to see the evidence. Scientists want to see the data. Data is facts, figures, and other evidence collected during a scientific investigation. Show me what it is to prove your point. Empirical evidence is what scientists are looking for. Empirical evidence is data that is collected using scientific processes that describe particular observations. In other words, you may notice that your light isn't working. Is the problem with the light bulb, or is the problem at the light switch, or is the problem somewhere else? What data do you collect using your scientific processes of observation, prediction, and inference to determine what evidence you have of why the light is not? Once you've collected your data, once you've collected all of your evidence, now you have to analyze it and come up with some sort of reasoning for why things are happening. Why isn't this light on? There are two types of reasoning. The first one we're going to look at is objective reasoning. Objective reasoning is reasoning that is based on evidence. So, you check the light switch. You check the bulb. You go check the circuit board to make sure that you haven't blown a fuse. You look up and down the street to see if other lights are on or off in the neighborhood. You go to other rooms in the house, turning the switches on and off. What evidence do you gather? How do you make this objective reasoning, this decision about what is possibly happening with the light in the room? The second type of reasoning is subjective. The second type of reasoning is subjective. Subjective reasoning is reasoning that is based on personal feelings or personal values. So, your light is out. This light goes out all the time. It's the dumbest light in the world. It's out because it's just a dumb light. That's your subjective, personal feeling about the matter. But, is it scientific? Our final term is pseudoscience. Pseudoscience is a set of beliefs that may make use of science. Magic is an example of pseudoscience. There might be some science there, but how much science is really there? The conclusions and predictions of pseudoscience are not based on observation, objective reasoning, or scientific evidence. Science is based on empirical evidence and well-reasoned interpretation of data. Pseudoscience, on the other hand, may make use of scientific data, but again, the conclusions of pseudoscience are based on subjective reasoning, faulty reasoning, or faulty beliefs, not on careful examination of the evidence.